Hi friends, welcome to the accountancy class. Cash flow statement is a statement which is prepared to know the inflows and outflows of cash. The total transactions of a company can be divided into three: operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. Next, we are going to study how to prepare cash flow statement for calculating cash flow from operating activities. For preparing or for calculating cash flow from or used in operating activities, first we want to calculate net profit before tax and extraordinary items. The rule for calculating net profit before tax and extraordinary items are: first, consider the difference of profit and loss account credit balance. Suppose the opening balance of profit and loss account is 60,000 and second year balance is 80,000, there is an increase of 20,000. In that case, consider 20,000 as positive figure. Then add any amount transferred to reserves, then closing balance of provision for taxation, closing balance of proposed dividend, closing balance of final dividend, and closing balance of interim dividend. By adding these items, you will get net profit before tax and extraordinary items. Then add non-cash and non-operating expenses. These non-cash and non-operating expenses include depreciation, loss on sale of machinery, goodwill, patent, copyright, mining rights written off, discount on issue shares, etc. After calculating these non-operating and non-cash expenses, deduct non-operating and non-cash incomes. It includes profit on sale of machinery, any income received. It may be in the form of dividend received, interest received, rent received, etc. Then find out the closing balance. Then add all these items. Then deduct these items from the net amount. Then you will get cash before working capital adjustments. Working capital means current assets minus current liabilities. The rule for making the adjustments of working capital is add decrease in current assets and increase in current liability, less increase in current asset and decrease in current liability. Then you will get, after making these adjustments, you will get cash flow before extraordinary items or tax. Then make the adjustments of income tax. Deduct income tax during the year. Then you will get cash used in or cash flow from operating activities. Now we are going to solve one problem. The question is to calculate cash flow from operating activities. Here on the asset side, fixed assets given, then investment balance given, stock, debtors, bank balance also given. On the liability side, share capital balance, general reserve balance, profit and loss account balance, creditors account, tax provision, mortgage loan also given. On adjustment, investment costing 8,200 were sold for rupees 8,500. Tax provision made during the year 9,000. During the year, part of the fixed assets costing 10,000 was sold for rupees 12,000, and the net profit was, and the profit was included in profit and loss account. You are required to prepare cash flow from operating activities. Then in this problem, first we want to calculate net profit before tax and extraordinary items. Here profit and loss balance given, the opening stock 56,000 and closing stock 68,000. There is an increase in the profit, that is 12,000. So first take as net profit after tax amount 12,000. Then add any amount transferred to general reserve. Here the opening balance is 3 lakh rupees, then closing balance is 3 lakh 10,000. There is a transfer of 10,000 in general sale account. So we want to add the difference amount with net profit after tax and extraordinary items. Then provision for taxation, taxation provision 75,000 and 10,000 given. Then at the same time in adjustments, provision made during the year also given. So for in this adjustment, we want to open provision for taxation account, credit opening balance and debit closing balance, then tax paid during the year, end that transaction, then find out the closing balance, then make the adjustment of closing balance with the in the net profit calculation. Add the amount transferred to general reserve and tax paid during the year with net profit after tax and extraordinary items, then you will get tax and extraordinary items. Next step is add non-cash and non-operating expenses. In that step, first we want to add depreciation. Then if there is any writing of goodwill, patent, copyright, that item should be add with the net profit. Then if there is any loss on sale of machinery, that item also add with the net profit. Then find out the net balance. Then if there is any income or profit on sale of machinery, deduct that amount from the net amount. In balance sheet, fixed assets, there is an opening balance of 4 lakh rupees, then closing balance of 3 lakh 30 thousand. That means there is a decrease in the decrease of 70,000. The difference amount is known as depreciation. So transfer that amount of depreciation to operating activity statement. Add that amount with the net profit. Next step is make the adjustment of working capital. Working capital means current assets minus current liability. The rule for entering working capital changes is decrease in current asset and increase in current liability added. Then increase in current assets and decrease in current liability deduct. Here stock of rupees 2,40,000 and current year balance of 2,10,000. That means decrease of 30,000. So we want to add that amount. Same rule will be applicable in other current assets and current liability. Then deduct tax paid during the year. Then after deducting tax paid during the year, you will get cash flow from or cash used in operating activities.